Previously, we have talked about chapter 9, that is types of markets around us. And in the third and fourth units, you have already learned these chapters. And you know or you knew about the different markets that we have got in the country. And in these chapters, we have discussed about the different markets, that is the weekly markets, then the market which is a neighborhood, then also the market which is known as a shopping mall or maybe the complexes. And again, the wholesale market and a retail shop market. These are the things we have discussed in the previous chapter. And today, the chapter, this is a new chapter. For example, today, the chapter 10, the role of market intermediaries. Now, in this chapter also, you will see that there are some of the things are related with this chapter. So let me write the title of this chapter. What intermediaries? What is the meaning of this intermediaries? Now, this is the board, the classroom board, and I am here. And you are the third person. I'm the second person, and here the first person is the board. I have not seen that person, but the board is the first person of the. The term intermediaries. Now I was talking about that I am the middle person and here the first one is the blackboard and the, you are the one third person. Now, when we speak about the intermediaries, it means there is a farmers. Farmers. Farmers is the first person. This is the, we can say the production house. What?
Production
house. Yes, production house. Okay, then from the farmers, a person comes, he is like a middleman, okay, middleman, and from there, it is coming to the customer. Now we are speaking about the market. So this chapter is all about the market. Since in the previous chapter, we learned about the different types of markets. Now see, the farmers, the primary source we can say, farmers are producing the crops and here they are not going directly to the market or the crops are not directly after making, coming to the customer. Have you seen any time farmers is giving direct to our home? Not yet. We are not getting anything from the farmers. So we are, first of all, from where we are getting? From the retail shop. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
From the retail shop, whatever the portable items we are actually taking. So these are from the, we are getting the, from the retail shop. Retail. Understood? Now, so we are the customers and farmers. So he is the first person and there is one middleman. This middleman is dealing with the farmers, how much money needed for this crops. And then this middleman is dealing with the different crops and then he is making the stock and then he is bringing to the customer. So he has got a big role. He has got a big role to play. Middleman. Today in the retail shop and all, the items that we are getting for the oil, cosmetic, or maybe the clothes, all these items are actually we are getting from the market. These are from where? From the wholesale we are getting. And a wholesale getting from where? From the production house, where the things are produced. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So that's why. So you have to understand that how this middleman is playing the big role in the in this business, so that we have to understand from this chapter. Now see, there are some of the basic points are mentioned in this chapter. That is about the journey of goods to the market. Now what is the meaning of journey of goods to the market? Now goods directly from the farm doesn't come to our home, doesn't come to our door. But here are many processes they are going through. Many processes. Okay. So let me talk about some of the market that we have got. Now see, why intermediary is actually required? Why this intermediary is required for us to get the product from the disassembled man or maybe the from the intermediaries? Now see, actually the middleman or the intermediaries are passing the information. We have to know they are passing information. If they will not pass information, then we will not able to produce the number. Now see, what about information? Middleman only the person who will come to know that what you actually looking for. Yes or no? Suppose you go to the shop and you say, I need this one metal. That carved metal is not available. So what the middleman will think of? Okay. The shopkeeper retail the shop, he will be informing to this middleman saying that we need this type of production because people are looking for. So ultimately middleman goes to the that production house and then he will be searching and bringing it and he will be providing this particular item to that shop. So following day we go and we get it. You know, sometimes shopkeepers are saying that, oh, this item is not there, but maybe in the evening or tomorrow come, I'll provide it. Saying no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, have you heard when you're going to buy any of the items?
Yes, sir.
That time what they do? They inform to that person, one who is bringing the items. So he's the middleman, he's the intermediary. So this intermediary is going to the production house where this production is made. And then they are bringing and providing in the retail shop. Okay? So that is the person who is passing the information. And then again, second point we have to remember, attraction of the customers. Now middlemen, only the people or the intermediaries, only the person who is attracting the customers. Now suppose he will not bring the very attract items, we will not be able to. Let's see, we are going for the birthday party. And then we look for some items which is colorful, shiny, and it should be good quality. So that my friend, one who is celebrating birthday, he may look this guy gift and he will be happy. So we look for such kind of items. So the intermediaries should know. I mean, he will come to know that the customers what type of items needed. So they are bringing up that very colorful and shining items so that customers are able to buy it for themselves. Okay, so that is attraction, he said, really. Then again, he is providing also fund. Intermediaries are actually the people who are providing the fund sometimes. You can see sometimes these intermediaries are actually giving the fund for the different sections of the people, customers, and making them to be part of that business. So that is we can find it. And then we have got the wholesale and retail shop. Now see, wholesale and retail shop, in the country we have the two types of market. That is the wholesale and retail shop. Now see, let's see. This wholesale, one who is starting the wholesale, what he is going to do? He will go to the production house and then he will buy the production of that rate. For the production house, that rate is okay. Suppose he is selling one toothpaste by 30 rupees. 30 rupees. Then in this 30 rupees, in the production he got 30 rupees. But production house will be informing this wholesale man that you sell this production by 35 rupees. Now, wholesale is why we say the wholesale? Because here the quantity of the product is more. Why it is more? Reason behind is that he has to pay the tax, then electric bill, phone bill, many other things are there. So at that time he has to increase the price. And from the original price, the wholesale will be selling some high price. And from the wholesale, the retail shop will be coming and retail shop will make maybe 40 rupees. So we should know what is the actual price of the toothpaste in the production house. It means including here all the taxes, the retail shop will be selling this product in 40 rupees. So rupees 40, who is gaining? The retail shop. And more than lesser than that, the wholesale got. And then a production house. It means customer is paying the highest amount of money. It means we are giving more money and at the same time we are also giving the tax for that goods. So knowingly, unknowingly, we are paying the tax. Each product that we are buying from the market, we are paying the tax. Today you go to buy one sweet also, there is a